In the previous video, we saw that in order to use the MOSFET as an amplifier, you have first to bias the transistor at an operating point, a DC operating point in the middle of the saturation region. And we explained how you choose your DC operating point in the middle of saturation on this saturation region on this curve. On the other curve, it corresponds to that you need to choose your operating point in the middle of the saturation region, which means that this is the saturation region. It starts from increasing VGS, starting from here. You increase VGS, this is all the saturation region until you reach here. And you shouldn't choose the operating point close to the off, and you shouldn't choose it close to the triode region. So a bad choice for an operating point is to choose your operating point here, for example. This is close to the off, right? This is a bad choice for the operating point because it's close for close to the off region. And also, this is a bad choice. This is a bad choice of the operating point. Why? Because it is close to the triode region. As we said, if you choose your operating point close to the off or close to the triode region, your output signal will be distorted. It will be either clipped or distorted from one side. So a good choice for the operating point is to choose it in the middle of the saturation region. For example, if you take this curve here, VGS, for example, 2.5, this is, it will give you a point, an operating point here. So this point now is in the middle of the saturation region. It's far from the off, it's far from the triode region. So this is a good choice of the operating point. Okay, so this is basically what we a summary of what we said in the previous video. Okay, how to bias the transistor, how to operate the transistor at a certain operating point. There are many ways and many connections that we can use in order to bias the transistor. So I'm going to show you some biasing techniques, and we'll see that some of them are better than the others, and some of them they have different applications from the other. Okay, so let's see now some biasing techniques. The first biasing technique is the one that we discussed in the explanation of using the MOSFET as an amplifier, which is just connecting a battery to VGS, fixing VGS. So the biasing technique, the first biasing technique, is biasing by fixing VGS, which is basically, if this is your transistor, you connect the source to the ground, and then you connect here a battery VGS. You are forcing VGS to have a fixed value. This is the first biasing technique. But this biasing technique is not good. It's not practical. Why is that? Because usually when you go buy a certain type of transistor, with a certain serial number, it's supposed to be with a certain characteristics. Imagine the two of you will go buy the same transistor with the same serial number from the same shop. You will find that although these two transistors, they have exactly the same serial number, same model, same type, but you will find that the characteristics might be different. So if you plot the characteristics of that transistor that your colleague number one bought, okay, you will find that the characteristics, the relation between IGS and VGS looks like this. While the same transistor or like a similar transistor of the same type, same serial number, same everything, it has a different characteristics. Why is that? Because this is, practically speaking, we have a tolerance in the manufacturing process. So you will never find two transistors that have identical characteristics. Although both transistors are of the same type, same model, same serial number, same factory even, okay, but they will have two different characteristics. It's impossible to have two transistors with identical characteristics, exactly identical characteristics. So two students two of your colleagues will go buy the theoretically the same transistor, but one of them will get this characteristics, while the other one will get this characteristics. Now, if you fix VGS, you will find that the difference between the current that you will get from the first transistor and the current that you will get from the second transistor is very big. So your friend number one will get this current. Your friend number two will get this current. Although both of them, they thought that they bought the same transistor. Both of them, they think that they have exactly the same transistor, but they will get two different results. And the difference between the current of the first one and the current of the second one is huge. Why is that? This is because you fixed VGS, and this is a bad biasing technique. Another biasing technique that might solve this problem or reduce the effect of this problem is by biasing, by fixing VG, not VGS, by fixing VG and using a resistance at RS. So instead of fixing VGS like this, we connect the resistance here, we connect the resistance here, and we fix VG to a certain value. So now the voltage of VG is fixed, but not VGS, it's VG only, okay? And since we have a resistance here, the voltage of the source is not known, and we have to calculate it. So here, what's the benefit? This is number two, this is biasing technique number two, fixing VG and using a resistance RS. What's the benefit of this? The benefit of this is now we have a relation. We can get a relation between VGS and IDS, the current IDS. We can get another relation from the circuit. What's the relation? The relation is VG, we can write KVL for this loop at the gate source loop. If we write KVL, we'll find that VG equals VGS plus IDS RS, right? Which means that IDS equals VG minus VGS minus VGS over RS, which is a linear relation. This linear relation can be plotted as a line like this. So now if one of you go and buy a transistor with this characteristics, and the other one goes and buy the same transistor, but it happens that he will get a different characteristics, okay? This is IDS and VGS. So this is the characteristics of device number one, and this is the characteristics of device number two, but we have a relation, another relation between IDS and VGS. This relation is a line or a linear relation that looks like this, okay? When VGS is zero, IDS will be VG over RS, and when VGS is VG, the current will be zero. This relation comes from KVL, while this relation comes from the physics of the first transistor, this relation comes from the physics of the second transistor. So the operating point of the first transistor will be the intersection between the physics and KVL. The operating point of the first transistor will be here. This is the operating point of the first transistor. The operating point of the second transistor will be the intersection between the physics of the second transistor and the KVL. So the operating point of the second transistor will be here. Look at the difference now between the two currents that your two friends got. The first friend, your first colleague, your first friend, he got this current, while your second friend, he got the current in purple here. The difference is very small. Compare this to the case where you fix VGS. If VGS is fixed, let's say here, the first one will get this current, the second one will get this current. See the difference? If you fix VGS, if you fix VGS to this value, for example, one of them will get this current, while the other will get this current. See the difference between the two currents? This is the difference. While now, if you fix VG and you add a resistance RS to the transistor, to the source of the transistor, the difference between the two currents will be very small. Why do I care about the current, about the difference in the current between the two devices? Because the current affects the output. When the current changes, IDS changed, the output of the transistor, the output of the amplifier will change very much. The biasing point will change very much, right? That's why I care about the value of IDS. So here, practically speaking, again, if you go by two devices of the same type, not necessarily that they will be identical. You will find that there is a difference in the characteristics between the two devices. If you fix VGS, you will find that the difference between the two biasing points, the two currents, is very big. While if you do the second biasing technique with like fixing VG and adding RS, you will find that the difference will be very small between the two currents that you got from the two devices. So that's why the second biasing technique here is much better than the first biasing technique. How to implement in practice, how to implement this biasing technique, fixing VG, they implement it in two ways. One way, they use a voltage divider. Why they use a voltage divider? Because they want to use the same voltage supply VDD that used with the drain, they want to use it here. To save, instead of adding another voltage supply, VG, they use the same voltage supply here, VDD, and then they use a voltage divider to get the voltage, the required voltage VG at the gate. Or they can add a negative supply to the source. They can add a negative supply to the source, and here, like a big resistance to the gate. This big resistance is benefit, because some of you may ask, why don't we connect the gate directly to the ground? This will appear, or the benefit of this will appear when we study the AC circuit, the amplifiers, okay? Because if you connect the gate to the ground, this will make the input resistance look like zero. And we want always the input resistance of the amplifier to be huge, to be large, right? That's why you connect here a large resistance, so that when you connect the rest of the amplifier, the input resistance will be very large. Okay, same argument for these two resistors. These two resistors must be very large, okay? So that the input resistance of the amplifier will be large. Anyways, so they connect a large resistance here, okay? And we use another negative voltage supply. Another negative voltage supply here. This will do the same implementation, or this is one implementation of this biasing technique of fixing VG and adding resistance RS. So instead of adding a voltage VG here, they add a negative voltage V, negative VSS here. It will do the same thing in this loop. It will do the same effect in this loop. So these two circuits are two practical implementations of this biasing technique. So this is the theory, and this is practical implementation of the biasing technique. They can implement it using one voltage supply VDD or two voltage supplies VDD and negative VSS. Two other biasing techniques are biasing by drain gate feedback. So we talked about this before in the DC analysis. If you connect the drain and the gate by a resistance, and this resistance again must be very large for reasons that will appear later in the amplifier, when we study the amplifier circuit, it must be very large. You cannot use a short circuit, because if you use a short circuit, the input and the output will be the same thing, right? If you use a short circuit, the input signal and the output signal will be the same. So no amplification. There is no amplification. So that's why you have to make this resistor very large. Anyways, you connect the drain and the gate. This guarantees that the transistor will be in saturation for sure, right? And then you can control where in saturation by choosing a proper value for RD, and this is one biasing technique, is using the drain gate feedback. The fourth biasing technique is by using a current source. The current source, this is the best one. This is one of the best biasing techniques. Why? Because it fixes the current. You guarantee that the current will be fixed at a certain value. The DC current will be, the DC operating point will be fixed at a certain DC current. Even if the transistor changed, even if the characteristics of the transistor changed, the current, you fix it to a certain value. So this is one of the best biasing technique, is by using a constant current source. And how do they implement this current source? We discussed this before. They implement this current source using the current mirror. Why? Because in the IC, usually they want everything to be made out of transistors. So they implement the current source using transistors, okay? So on the IC, on the integrated circuit, everything, all the elements on the integrated circuit, which is made out of semiconductor material, everything will be implemented using the transistors, the MOSFET transistors. So they implement this current source in practice using this current mirror, and they can control the current by controlling the current in this side. The current automatically in the other side will be controlled. Okay, and we discussed the current mirror in a previous video before. So all these are different biasing techniques. This is the best one. This is also a good biasing technique. However, the first biasing technique, which is fixing VGS, was a poor biasing technique because it leads to, if the device has a different characteristics, it will lead to a big change in the biasing or operating point, which leads to maybe change in the amplification gain and many properties of the amplifiers. So basically, these are the different biasing techniques of the MOSFET techniques that we choose the bias point with. Okay, once we choose the bias point, you inject your AC signal or your signal to be amplified, superimposed over the input or over the DC input, okay, and it will be amplified. We'll see you in the next video with the small signal models, how the small signals see the transistor. So we'll have to do model the transistor with respect to the small signal and use it in the analysis of the amplifiers. See you in the next video.